welcome to Tips and Tricks. Today we have a quick video to show you how to delete the Windows Bootcamp partition off of your Mac computer if you've decided that you don't need to run it anymore. When you load Bootcamp on your computer, you're able to boot into Windows natively on the Mac. And if you check down in the description or in the card here, I can show you how to load Windows on your Mac through Bootcamp. But eventually you may decide that you don't need Windows on your computer anymore. Maybe you bought a PC. Maybe you really need to free up some space on your hard drive, because it does take up space on your hard drive. So you'd like to get rid of that partition. And what happens when you run the Bootcamp installer is that it leaves your normal Macintosh hard drive intact, but adds this Bootcamp partition where Windows is loaded. And you can actually click in there and see everything to do with Windows and the program files that are loaded and so on. But when you want to get rid of it, you can't just drag it into the trash. There's no way to do that. So the best way is to open up your utilities folder. So we'll open a new Finder window. Go to Applications, scroll down until you see Utilities. You can also hit Command-Shift-U, and that's the quick key to get to the Utilities folder. And we will open up our Disk Utility. And within Disk Utility, we can modify all the partitions on the disk. So to do that, we have our two partitions here. We click on the physical hard drive itself, and then the partition icon will become available. You'll see if we're on either one of the partitions, it's grayed out because we can't do anything with it. So click on your top level physical drive, hit partition, and then you can see how much space is taken up by the Macintosh partition and how much space is taken up by the Bootcamp partition. We click on partition, and now we have the ability to control our partitions. We can actually go in here, we can change the sizes and so on, but in this case we're going to delete the partition. So remember, when you delete the partition, you're deleting everything within Windows. So if you've done a lot of work in Windows, you've saved files in Windows and so on, make sure you back them up. You can save them out to a USB flash drive or an external hard drive or something like that. But do make sure you back up everything that you need, because your Windows will be gone and gone forever after we do this. So you click once on your Bootcamp partition. Just make sure that it says Bootcamp in here so that you're not messing around with your Macintosh partition, because that'll be disastrous for your computer if you damage this partition. So again, click on the Bootcamp partition. Make sure it's listed here. It shows what file system it is, Windows file system, the size, and so on. Now we can hit the minus button down here, and it shows what will happen after the change. It'll devote everything to the Macintosh HD partition. We hit apply, and it gives us an extra warning to remind us that everything's going to be deleted off there. We know that's okay, we want to do it. So we hit partition, and it will process for a little while and finish removing the partition, and it does it live. Our partitioning operation is now complete, and the Done button becomes available. We can hit Done, and then we can see that the Bootcamp partition has disappeared off of our drive, and we only have one partition now in the Disk Utility. The whole partition now is dedicated to the Macintosh hard drive, and it's available for our use. So that is how you delete the Bootcamp partition off of your Macintosh when you want to get rid of Windows, you don't need to use it anymore. I hope this tip was helpful for you, and I hope you're able to successfully delete your Bootcamp partition. If the video was useful and you liked it, please hit the thumbs up. It really helps us out a lot. And subscribe to our channel. We're coming out with new videos all the time, almost daily, on new tips and tricks and how to get the most out of your Macintosh. And please share this video with friends and family and neighbors and colleagues in case they can find this tip useful. And also, leave a comment. Leave a comment to tell us, how do you use Windows on your computer? When did you stop needing to use Windows? And also, if you have any suggestions for new topics that we can put on the channel, please put that down in the comments below. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.